In a new report, we've been told that the MacBook Air 2022 model will be released at WWDC this year. Today, I want to cover over the potential if this is going to really happen and who the leak is from. I will also be giving you all the latest details for the new MacBook Air M2, with giving you everything on the specs and the latest on the MacBook Air 2022 release date and price. But let's get started with what we have with the current MacBook Air. Well, it's been over a year since we had an update to the MacBook Air. The biggest change we saw in that last model was the new Apple Silicon M1 chipset put inside, and also the cooling fan being removed from the model. But this year, in 2022, some big changes are expected, even further than what we got with the M1 MacBook Air. So, moving on. We've just had a report from Mark Gurman, who has basically said that if Apple talk about the M2 chipset at WWDC, then the new M2 MacBook Air will be released with it. Now, from my point of view, I personally don't think this is going to be happening, and I'd love to be surprised that if it does come out, you know, I would love to get my hands on it this summer, but I just don't think it's going to happen. One thing to be aware of right now is there's been some manufacturing problems, mainly to do with COVID in China, and this has slowed down productions a lot on new Apple products. I'm talking about new Apple products that have come out in the last year. It's believed that Apple won't want to release a new product with a good stockpile before releasing it. So for example, like with the latest MacBook Pros that came out last sort of October, November time, you know, any kind of slight customizations on it will push back your order of a MacBook Pro all the way to August time. And I've just done this here, as you can see, just by adjusting the RAM, and it pushes it right out. The same with the Mac Studio that got announced back in March time. Just adjusting the storage from 1 terabyte to 2 terabytes pushes it out by 12 weeks to September, what is ages away. Probably the new iPhone 14 will be out around about that time. So to be honest, I don't think it'd be a good move. And to be honest, I think it'd be a very odd move to Apple to release the MacBook Air and then to run out of stock almost instantly. And then we'd have to wait loads and loads of weeks or even months to get our hands on one. Don't get me wrong, like I said, if Apple did announce a brand new MacBook Air at WWDC, I'll try my hands to get on one as soon as possible, like many of you guys, but I just don't believe this is what Apple are going to do. But we've also got to remember one thing, and that is what WWDC stands for. WWDC stands for the Worldwide Developers Conference. This mainly means there is a focus on software for developers with the current Apple hardware that is available and supported right now. Right now, many developers create apps for the iPhone, iPad, Apple Watch, Apple TV, HomeKit, and of course, macOS. Generally speaking, in the last 15 years plus, Apple have not really announced any new MacBooks at WWDC. In fact, they haven't really announced any new Macs at WWDC except for one category, what is the Desktop Pro range. So I'm talking about the Tower Mac Pro with the three different versions that have come out since 2006 all the way to 2019. And also, we did 1 year get that iMac Pro that was going to be the replacement of the Mac Pro, and that came out in 2017. Apart from this, there are no other Macs that have been announced at WWDC. With this in mind, it is likely that in 2022, this isn't going to change again. And for this, it's very unlikely we're going to see the new M2 MacBook Air revealed at WWDC. However, you're probably wondering, when will we get our hands on the MacBook Air? And I will tell you this in just a moment. But, like a few of my other videos, just a quick note here. With any of these leaks, even up to the new MacBook Air's release date that I find and show you guys, a lot of previous leaks for other Apple products have come true, but there are sometimes some that get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I have been told and shown. No leak or rumor is 100% true until we see the final MacBook Air being officially shown from Apple. However, if you are like me and if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation MacBook Air is going to be like and want to know what the latest leaks and rumors are, no matter what they tell us. So, release date. As we've now had the March event called Peak Performance, what focused mainly on the Mac Studio, on the Mac side of things, obviously we did have the iPhone SE and the new iPad Air, this means the next event is WWDC. But at this event, we're expecting to see the new Mac Pro, and maybe talks about the M2 generation, what will be put into Macs throughout the next 2 years. With that, it's expected the MacBook Air will probably be one of the first devices to actually get one of the M2 chipsets inside it, and it's most likely it'll be coming out for this year in October or November time, as by this point the M1 MacBook Air will be approaching 2 years old and could do with a wanted upgrade. As already mentioned before, Min-Chi Kuo agrees with this and has said the MacBook Air is coming later on in 2022, and generally for the last few years, we've had a Mac event always around the time just after the iPhone launch, so this tends to be in October and November time. For the official date of an event or when the MacBook Air will officially be in our hands, it's a little too early to say at this point, but everything is pointing towards between mid-October to mid-November time this year. Yeah, and of course, the second we know when the actual Apple event is, it's most likely we will know the time of when we'll be able to get the MacBook Air in our hands. So make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell to get further updates on the MacBook Air. So, just quickly guys, this channel recently got over 350,000 subscribers, what's absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I am doing a giveaway right now on this channel for this. It is for a MacBook Air, and this MacBook Air here is the 8-core GPU option with 512 gigabytes of storage, and I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear or what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And when we get over that 400,000 subscribers marker, I'll be creating a video on this channel announcing who the winner is. So if you are new here, make sure to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell right now. Now, just quickly, I do want to mention there are lots of scammers, there are lots of spammers, a lot of them impersonating myself, and they're telling you to WhatsApp you or to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them. Ignore them completely or report them, because this is not me. Like you've heard from me here, I'll be making a video when we get over 400,000 subscribers announcing any kind of giveaway on this channel, and it will definitely be this time for this MacBook Air here. Well, with that out of the way guys, let's return back to the video. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the 2022 MacBook Air is going to give us with its prices. So first of all, the actual display. It's going to be a 13.3 LED Retina display with a resolution of 2560 by 1600. Now right away, the first thing you might have noticed, it's not a ProMotion display, so it does not mean it has a adaptive refresh rate. This is not going to be inside the new MacBook Air. It's going to be a standard 60 hertz panel inside it, very similar to what we had with the MacBook Air M1 and like the likes of say the 13 inch MacBook Pro as well. So basically no big changes there, just a normal LED Retina display inside this MacBook Air M2. For storage, it's likely it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, so 256 gigabyte, 512, 1 terabyte and 2 terabyte storage options. There will be that brand new M2 chipset inside it, and it is likely, according to the latest leaks, what I will cover more in other videos, to be an 8-core CPU and also a 10-core GPU at the moment. There will also be the option again of 8 gigabytes or 16 gigabytes of RAM to pick for your MacBook Air. The actual design is going to be a completely new design, as you can see here. It's likely it's going to be a little bit more thinner than the MacBook Air we have right now, but we're also going to be getting colors as a first, according to some of the latest leaks and rumors. But it will be made out of aluminium, and there will still be 2 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on one side, and also those Thunderbolt 4 ports will be also compatible with USB 4. The new design, what I just spoke about, the new colors ranges that are coming out for it will be blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange and purple, what are the exact same colors that we got with the iMac M1. It's also likely we've been told that there's going to be a center stage webcam in the middle of the new MacBook Air, what will be a 12 megapixel camera. Battery life is going to be the same what we're getting right now, so up to 18 hours if you use it well. And then prices wise, it looks likely that it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, with 256GB starting at $999, 512GB at $1,249, 1TB at $1,499, and 2TB at $1,849. Now, obviously, all these specs that I've just shown you here are based on what we know at the moment. This could change in the future. But next, for my wishes for the MacBook Air. My wish is to do with the colors. So we've seen some great colors in the concepts and renders that you're looking at right here. But also there are some rumors and leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is going to have all these multiple different colors that are going to be very similar to the iMac and the iPad Air, for example. However, I would like to still have the ability to buy a silver, a gold, or a space gray MacBook Air like we can right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with having this kind of choice or not. Also, at the same time, write in the comments what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Air in 2022. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon. Bye.